was many and many a year ago, in a kingdom by the sea, that a maiden there lived, whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee.
Thank you. Alex, this is what you wanted, I believe. Sorry it took so long. But we're very short-staffed, and it took a great deal of persuading for the archive to let it go.
Thank you, Denise. That's very kind of you to go to so much trouble.
The book's reference only, I'm afraid. I'll leave you to it, then. Going already? Alex? See you tomorrow then.
You're a pal. Here, got another. Thanks. Thanks, pal.
Sorry to have kept you waiting. I heard you, but I was on the phone. Now, can I help you in any way? I received this morning, telling me to come for an interview. When did you say you got this?
This morning. It says to come today at 5.
Yes, I see that, only I don't remember sending it.
Well, so there isn't a job vacancy?
Well, yes, there is, actually. I was about to put in an ad, only I hadn't got round to it yet. It's most odd. Still, now you are here, you better come and sit down and have a chat. We are terribly short-staffed. I suppose head office must have sent this out. Either that, or I'm getting even more forgetful than I thought. It's overwork, you know. Actually, I'm terribly glad to see you. I've been on my own for over a month now, and it's far too much for a single member of staff.
Excuse me, Denise. I'm sorry to bother you again, but I need the manuscripts relating to the 5th century Alexandria riots. I could photocopy what I need and let you have them back immediately.
Do you need it urgently?
I do rather.
Okay, I'll go and make a phone call. Do you mind hanging on for a moment?
Into the usual, please. Actually, can you take that back?
And girls come out to play. Moon is shining bright as day. Leave your supper and leave your sleep. Join your playfellows in the street. Come with a hoop.
Ready for a break? There's coffee and a kettle in the office, or tea if you prefer it.
Oh, I wouldn't mind.
Come on. How are you getting on?
Well, it's a bit strange at first, but I'm getting used to it.
It's your first day. It takes time to learn all the different sections. I've had some assistants who never mastered it, but you're not going to be one of those.
I hope not.
One of the things you do have to watch out for are some of the regulars. One or two of them can be a bit of a handful. Not the genuine researchers, but those who take up residence because they've nowhere else to go.
Like the magazine man.
Well, he's one of them. He just doesn't want anyone else to touch his magazines. Otherwise, he's harmless. He used to be quite a scholar in his time, I believe. At least I know he won't disturb the people with real work to do. Alex, for example. Now, he's a real scholar. He's writing a thesis about religious martyrs, people who were burned at the stake, that sort of thing.
This is an unusual place.
Unique. That's why we attract people like Alex. He's always so appreciative of what we do for him. Still, not everyone can be like that. In a way, I like to think of us as a sort of family. All the individual members with their own little foibles to be catered for.
Hmm.
I suppose you think that's foolish.
No, not at all. There should be room for everyone. Perhaps we should be getting back to work.
You're right. Duty calls.
Do you like Fornery?
Do you know him?
Poet, novelist, dramatist, early precursor of surrealism, French.
That's right. You know, you're only the second person I've met who's even heard of Fornery in England, let alone read him. It's not your chosen subject, though, is it?
One of my favorite poems by Fornery is Le Pauvre Honteux. Do you know it? It's about a starving man who eats his own hand.
Yes, I know it. I had a friend who loved its quirkiness. You have very nice hands. You don't like being touched. I do. It's reassuring. I can be sure that the person's there. Now, give me your hand.
Why?
I can read palms.
I don't believe in all that.
Then don't. You live a long life, that's for sure. At least 80.
That's good to know.
You have the temperament of an artist. Probably don't have any trouble finding admirers. For For a scholar, you tend to be dangerously untidy in certain things. You may lose something very precious to you. If that happens, you'll never be able to find it again, so just forget about it.
How many men have you seduced in this way?
I think I better be going.
What are you doing here?
I've lost my way.
What's your name?
Virginia.
Day. Leave your supper and leave your sleep.
scared me.
I'm sorry. I've been looking for you.
For me? Why? What do you want?
I want to give you something. A present.
For me? Why?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, yes. Yes, it is.
Good. I'll get back to my studies then.
I should never have trusted the forecast.
I could have told you. The smell was becoming unbearable.
You smell rain?
Yes. Will you come for a coffee with me?
No, thank you. I want to get home. I need an early night.
Then take this.
What about you?
I don't mind.
You'll get soaked. You'll catch a cold.
I won't.
You could walk me home.
Then I will.
Will you? I hope it's not too out of your way.
It isn't.
Thanks.
I'll be on my way then.
Don't hurt me. I didn't see nothing. Honest, don't hurt me.
Why are you afraid of me? I gave you cigarettes. Don't you remember?
Know just what I want.
I mean your marriage.
But that won't make a difference. Besides, I'm sure Edgar will find you most agreeable.
Will he?
How could he not? Nothing can ever separate us. Forever and ever. There. I've promised.
Forever and ever.
You must have been very deeply in love. I see you come here almost every day. You work at the Foster Library, don't you?
Yes.
Are you happy in your new job? There is something exquisitely satisfying standing here amongst the dead on a beautiful morning.
I've never looked at it that way.
Perhaps it's an acquired taste.
Well, I'd better be off to work.
Maybe I'll see you at the library later.
Can I help you?
About that girl by those shelves over there.
Yes. She's our new assistant.
What do you think? Isn't she remarkable?
Yes. I'm very glad she came.
Hello, Denise.
Hello, Alex.
Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine, thank you.
The body of a man was found today off Dean Street in London, Soho. He was the principal witness in a brutal murder of a man and a 5-year-old girl. The police have now doubled their efforts to hunt for the murderer, who they suspect may be responsible for both of the killings. It's 9:15. Back to the music. This is the new one from June.
Oh, it's you. Hello.
Hello. Can I come in?
Yeah, sure. There's a power cut.
So I see.
It's very nice here.
It's all right. Sit down. Can I get you a tea or coffee?
Am I disturbing you?
Good to see you.
Then I'll have whatever you're having.
Vodka, then.
Vodka's fine.
Who's he?
A friend.
What's he like?
He's dead.
I'm sorry. Do you miss him?
Yes. What about you? Do you have someone?
I did. A long time ago.
You said that once before, a long time ago. It makes you sound like an old man. What happened?
Like you, I lost her. But I think about her all the time.
I want to be forgotten completely when I die. I want all trace of my existence to be completely wiped out. Just one of my romantic ideas.
There are some things that cannot be destroyed.
Are you talking about love?
Pain.
That passes. A year or two of grieving and you're over it. This is what matters. Here. Now. Now.
I must go.
you've used your magic again. I thought you weren't coming.
We made a vow.
You're not hurt. Were you able to get enough blood?
I managed.
Were you lonely, my love?
I thought of you always. Choose now. There is not much time. You can die a human death, or live on forever as an immortal beast.
I don't want to die. I'm afraid. I cannot bear for you to forget me. I want you never to stop thinking about me.
Then you will come with me.
Yes, Alex. I will. I will live with you forever and ever.
Virginia, where are you, Virginia?
Alex hasn't come today. I hope he's all right.
I've got the book he wanted. He's been asking for it urgently.
Expect he'll be in tomorrow.
I suppose it can wait till then. Excuse me, could you possibly give it back to him? I'm sorry, but he does get so distressed. If you come over to the magazine rack, I'm sure I could interest you in something equally good.
Thank you. This is what I want. There shan't be a moment.
Look, I wouldn't ask if it wasn't serious.
This is a public library.
I'm sorry. I don't wish to disturb your work.
Attending to people's part of my work, what can I do for you?
Forgive me, but I hate to see you looking low. You had seemed much more cheerful of late.
I'm fine, thank you.
It isn't any of my business, but it's such an intimate little world in here that one can't help noticing people. It isn't perhaps anything to do with that charming young man not being here today?
Of course not.
But you know who I mean.
Yes, I think so.
In my opinion, he needs the friendship of a strong young woman like yourself. Something vulnerable about him.
Do you always concern yourself with other people this way?
Obviously, some people are far more interesting than others.
Well, as you say, none of this is really any of your business.
You're right. It isn't. It isn't at all. I'm holding you up.
It's all right. I'm not terribly busy at present. Do you know him? Alex, I mean.
I have the feeling we met once, some time ago in France.
Oh, I see.
Look, what about a spot at dinner to show you're not angry with me?
I don't think so, thank you.
When was the last time you went out to dinner?
I can't remember.
There you are, then. Do you good. Give me the greatest pleasure.
You're very persuasive.
I hope so.
All right, then. But better make a quick dinner. I don't want to be home late.
We're closing now. I said we are closing.
With cherries. What are they like?
Kai or cerise, they are delicious. Would you like to try them?
Okay. Never had them before.
To start, I can recommend tripe demoiselle.
I think the kale will be plenty, thank you.
And to drink, a nice claret.
Fine.
Le caille, a green salad, a bottle of Chateau Lafite.
Very good, sir.
Come here often?
When I'm in London, it's quiet. The food is excellent.
What do you do?
Do?
I mean, what's your profession?
I'm a writer.
Really? Should I have heard of you? Have you been published much?
Quite a lot. I have to say, though, that in all my travels, I've rarely come across a library as fascinating as yours. You're very lucky to be working there.
Yes, I suppose I am. I'd never heard of it before. I just needed a job, and it came up, so I took it.
But you're glad now?
Yes, I am.
Fate often leads us in the right direction.
Are you studying those things? Mysticism and occult?
Well, they interest me a great deal. Vampires, especially.
Really?
But I suppose you haven't much tolerance for such superstitious nonsense.
Well, certainly if you think it's nonsense, it hardly seems a subject worth pursuing.
Oh, no. I was thinking how the ignorant and uninformed masses would take it.
But you know better.
Precisely. As a matter of fact, it is my sworn belief that vampires, mythical and metaphorical beings that they are, have by now turned into an everyday reality. I've traveled far and wide in search of evidence, and my studies have led me to believe that the most concrete and substantial evidence yet to be found on the subject is here in London.
It's very interesting. If you need the services of our library, I'd be happy to help.
I thank you. I'm sure that if I could enlist your help, my problems would vanish instantly. In truth, however, I'm pursuing a slightly different line of inquiry at the moment.
What's that?
A minor dramatic work of American origin. It's a highly poignant and tragic love story. Are you in love with Alex?
I don't think that's any of your business.
No, you're right. I'm concerned for you. I want us to be friends.
Well, I'm here, aren't I?
Yes, and I'm delighted to have your company. Perhaps I should explain. I did know Alex once. It was a long time ago. We had some sort of misunderstanding. I heard since that he had an unfortunate accident, lost his girlfriend.
I don't see what this has got to do with me.
Well, I was wondering if you would do something for me.
Like what?
I want to send them a gift, a token gesture of renewed friendship. Perhaps you will take it to him. I presume you know where he lives.
I'm sorry, but I really don't see why you think this has got anything to do with me.
Bon appetit.
Villager.
Well, they know.
I don't know. Somebody else like us.
Virginia. Quick.
You will come back.
Of course.
They mustn't get you.
They won't.
Promise.
Virginia, I've missed you so much.
Alex, are you all right?
Anne?
Come on, sit down. That better? What happened to you tonight?
I promised Virginia once that I would always be with her.
You can't feel guilty about a promise made to the dead.
She's alive.
Alive.
She's somewhere suffering. And there's nothing I can do to ease her pain. Her pain.
No one can take away another's pain. No one can do that for anyone. We can comfort one another a little.
The old man's died. I've just been informed on the phone.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yes. Oh, if Alex comes in, don't forget to tell him about his books. They're due back at the archive soon. He's here again.
Who?
Him, the man in the hat. Don't trust him an inch.
Good afternoon. I wonder what she's got against me. Wow. Well, this is a splendid development.
What?
This calls for a celebration. We'll go and have a drink.
I haven't got a clue what you're talking about. Besides, I've got work to do.
Make an excuse. It's almost closing time. There's things I need to tell you.
I'd really like to get on with my work, if you don't mind.
What he did to you last night. Do you want to know how I know? Come and have a drink with me. You'll regret it if you don't. I think you should be told of his secret.
What secret?
Will you come?
All right. I'll go and tell Denise. I'll meet you outside.
I'll be waiting.
You said you know Alex's secret.
You sure? You really want to know?
That's what I'm here for, isn't it?
Sometimes the truth isn't always so pleasant.
I'd rather face the truth than wallow in deception.
He will destroy you. He cannot help it. It is his nature.
Is that all?
You think that's nothing?
It's more of a judgment than a secret. Your judgment.
What I'm saying is a fact. Something so loathsome, I doubt it can be assimilated by a confident little schoolgirl's mind like yours.
Go on.
He lives by blood. It feeds and nurtures him. To kill is the greatest sensual delight he knows. We call such beings vampires. That is the man you think you love. It is the truth. I assure you, such beings as Alex inhabit the valley of unrest between life and death. They devour the living in a vain attempt to assuage their hunger. The emptiness and horrors for everlasting life. He will devour you. That is what the vampire calls love.
I don't believe you. I don't believe a word you're saying.
Why did you come here then? Isn't it because you yourself entertain some doubt about what Alex is and what he does? Tell me, what did he do to you last night? A love bite? But I have other proofs. Would you like to see them? This is a diary written by a 19th century American woman, Virginia Clem. It records her correspondence with Alex. You see this signature? Always yours, Alex. And there, 5th of February, 1846. Read all of them, if you like. 1827 to 1846. Quite a little archive.
And how do I know these are genuine?
Well, take them to an expert. Have them authenticated. The library will know someone. You recognize the handwriting, of course. Quite distinct. And then there is this. The work of Julia Margaret Cameron is very highly regarded these days, I believe. You must admit it's a remarkable resemblance to you, I mean.
I have to be going now. Thanks.
But we've only just started, and there's something else. All these unsolved murders, many of them look to me to be the work of a vampire. You cannot escape from the truth.
Thank you.
Go on. I will make it easy for you. I never thought you would follow me here. You have more courage than I believed.
You're a vampire, aren't you?
If you want to call it that.
You kill people for their blood.
Yes.
Will I become one too?
It's not that easy.
Why me? Because I look like her.
I'm sorry.
I'm going to kill you.
You would be doing me a great service.
Do you want to die? Why don't you kill yourself?
It's no use.
You mean you don't die?
Not as far as I know. But you can try. If anyone can do it, it's you.
Well, how do you expect me to do it? Just kill in cold blood?
Remember, I'm not strictly human.
The things that cannot be destroyed. You were talking about yourself then. This is very funny. Take me. I'll be another Virginia for you. Make me into a vampire.
No.
I want to be with you.
I can't. I've made this mistake before.
Alex!
Forgive me, dropping in so late. There's something I need to tell you.
You've told me enough already. It's finished.
No, no. It's just stopped.
You've left it a bit late this evening.
Where's Anne?
She isn't in today. She called in sick. I've been trying to get her on the phone, but I get the answering machine every time. I suppose she's just not up to taking calls. Is anything wrong?
I hope not.
I've longed to see your face like this, Alex. The man had killed the things he loved, so we had to die. Both are. I'm so glad to see you after all these years. I haven't introduced myself yet. I am Virginia's husband, Edgar. Moonlight never reaches her. She has been there a century. She will be there until the end of time.
Alex, have I bored you?
So much.
Alex.
Brilliant.
So were you, Anne. I haven't forgotten you. You were delightful. I can't tell you how much you remind me of my beloved wife, Virginia. She'd been made perfect in loveliness for the single purpose of attaining death. Unfortunately for her, she did not die. She dared to betray my high ideals. I had to punish her. Oh, you thoughtless Virginia. And Alex.
Drink.
Drink.
Drink! Anne! Anne! Ray!
For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and so all the night tide I lie down by the side of my darling, my life, and my bride. In the sepulchre, there by the sea, in her tomb, by the sounding sea.